Hi friends, this is a set to strengthen your energy field. So if you'd like, set a blanket up for your good knees and have some blocks for your good wrists. And we'll come into the first part, which is yogic push-ups. And we'll modify with a modified plank. So your knees come down. You're basically starting in table. However, then you want your hips to move forward. And my hands are shoulders width. So if you look down and your hands are closer or further, return to table, set your hands up, your toes are tucked under, remember a good foundation, and then those good hips come forward. And now my upper body, my hips and my thighs are in alignment with each other so that I can do those yoga push-ups. And what we want to do, if possible, is keep one foot grounded and lift the other foot. And exhale, your head moves to the mat. Inhale, lengthens the arms. Now you can do away with the blocks if you prefer. Or if you have books, that works too. And we'll try the other side. So the other knee comes down. You can take a moment and breathe. Slow, steady inhale. Slow, steady exhale. Other toes tuck under, other foot reaches back. Exhale, the elbows bend. Inhale, the arms lengthen. Return to table, breathe here a moment. Now, if possible, let's see what it's like without the blocks. I know some of you like to press into the tops of your hands to keep your wrist long in line with your hands and your arms. So, you know, you'll find what works for you. Push-ups might be a little tricky that way. I've also seen people push into their fingertips and bend. I'm going to press into the four corners of my palms. So that sneaky part that might lift up between the index finger and the thumb, I'm pressing down. And again, my hands need to move in front of my shoulders a bit more. Hips then in front of knees, and I'll keep my right toes tucked under, push my left heel back, and exhale to the floor. Inhale, lengthen the arms. So you know with these wonderful sets, they encourage us to start somewhere, and then eventually you're working up to 7.5 minutes on each side. Inhale, lengthen, take a moment, breathe. And let's do the other side, the left toes tucked, the right heel presses, exhale, bends at the elbows. Ooh, I didn't bring my hips forward this time, did I? I guess that would be an option then, wouldn't it? You could stay in your table and see if your head would move closer to the floor. Good to find different ways to modify, right? So we have to see what works for us. Let's see, if I bring my hips forward, aha, there it is. Right foot pushes. Exhale, release. Inhale, lengthen. Take a moment, breathe. Well done. Good work, right? We're asking the energy from the lower centers to make their way up to the higher centers, the glands, if you will. So come to sit now in a comfortable seat for you. You know you can prop as many blankets or cushions underneath your seat that works. And from your cross-legged position, I'm gonna even up my blanket here a bit. Your left hand will reach forward, so I look opposite you. Your right hand moves underneath. Your four fingers come on top, and then thumb on top, thumb on bottom. On an inhale, lift the arms so you're on a diagonal, and on an exhale, bring the arms in front of you. Let me try from the side in case you're able to see a little better. Left hand forward, right underneath, fingers on top, and then thumb and thumb. Inhale, lifting, exhale, releasing. The inhale, lift on a diagonal, the exhale, release in front of your shoulders. Keep moving with your breathing. Remember, you're allowed to take a moment and come back in when you're ready. And with this glorious second part of our exercise, you can work your way up to 15 minutes. Exhale, release, rest, slow, steady inhale. Slow, steady exhale. Move anything that's in your way out of the way so that your arms can reach forward. And then as they reach back, they move down a bit. Exhale, forward, inhale, open up. Moving with your breathing. This third and final part of your set, you made it to the final part, is for ripples. And so you're imagining this beautiful ripple of energy surrounding you, helping you to ward off disease, helping you to grow stronger in and of yourself, and helping you through those moments where we all may feel a little overly emotional. That's what this set is good for. Doing? Almost there. Slow, steady inhale. Slow, steady exhale. Breathe. Oh, feel those good, strong arms. We'll conclude our set with Breath of Fire. So you remember, it's a soft and fast breath where you're pulling in and up a bit at the navel center. And you're using your strength to do that. Your mouth is closed and the focus is on the exhale, leaving your nostrils. If you like, take a mudra with your hands. Inhale fully and begin. Exhale all the air out. How was that? Let's give it a try again. Remember, the more you practice, the more it will make sense to move more quickly. If it's not there for you at first, no worries. We practice. Inhale fully. Begin. Exhale all the air out, slow, steady inhale. Slow, steady exhale. Alternate nostril breathing balances the brain, and that is good for us all. Your right hand prepares. You can keep the four fingers together, and your right thumb will close the right nostril. You exhale left. Close, pause, exhale right, inhale, close, pause, exhale left, inhale, close, pause, exhale right. One more at your own pace. Next time you exhale, right hands meet in front of heart center, and we'll close with Satnam, meaning truth. May you have truth, may you be truth, may you share truth. Satnam, Satnam, Satnam. See you soon.